Here's a teaser. What if I told you that cures for chronic disease were hidden in our own immune systems? If only we could read that information out. So let's take multiple sclerosis, for example. Multiple sclerosis is a debilitating autoimmune disease where our own cells attack the brain. And for years, we didn't know what caused it, which makes it very difficult to treat. So in January 2022, a study came out where they followed 10 million people for 20 years. And they found that Epstein-Barr virus, so mono, the kissing disease, increased the risk of multiple sclerosis by 32 times. It's a big deal. You might have seen it in the news. So 3 days later, another study came out in Nature showing not just a correlation, but a direct link between Epstein-Barr virus and multiple sclerosis. Using just 12 people and sampling like once. So 10 million people, 20 years, 12 people, in like a day. How did they do that? So the team, Robinson and Lance, used a snapshot of information stored in our memory immune cells to infer backwards what had come before and triggered the disease, or what I like to call forensic immunology. And in Robinson's case, right, they already knew what they were looking for, Epstein-Barr virus, myelin. So they only had to decode a tiny part of the massive, distributed, ever-evolving archive that is the memory immune system. So the immune system stores an imprint of everything it encounters: infections, allergies, autoimmunity, toxins, cancer. It's basically a web browser history. It's also how vaccines work. So though we may not know what is causing a disease, the immune system probably does. And if we could decode the immune archive at scale, we could apply forensic immunology to diseases where we don't yet know the cause. So that is exactly what my team aims to do. And so I am thrilled to announce publicly, for the first time, Imprint, a forensic immunology-focused research organization, or FRO, building machine learning and experimental tools to identify the hidden causes of and cures for chronic disease. Currently, we are generously supported by Eric and Wendy Schmidt, Convergent Research, and the City of New York. We're also, yeah, New York, right? And everyone else. We're also going to apply these tools to intractable chronic diseases, particularly neurological and psychiatric disorders. So why neuropsych, right? Emerging evidence, including some of my own work, suggests that a lot of what we are calling psychiatric disorders are actually immune diseases. So for example, the immune system stores a memory of psychological stress and is involved in stress resilience. And a lot of cases of schizophrenia are actually turning out to be driven by underlying autoimmune disease. And the shingles vaccine might prevent dementia. And there's also everything that we saw during the pandemic, right? COVID causing de novo psychiatric disorders, long COVID. So really, we are in the middle of an immunotherapy revolution for cancer. Right? Some cancers that had 90% mortality rates 50 years ago now have 90% cure rates. What if we could extend that revolution to autoimmunity, diabetes, dementia, depression? Maybe in 15 years, if we can learn what the immune system already knows, we could take the chronic out of chronic disease. Thank you.